Right, Aki Kareem here for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined this morning by Portsmouth's Joel McIntyre, who is currently on a comeback trail at the age of 34, which is still young to me, to be honest, mate. But what has inspired this comeback?
More than anything, mate. Yeah, I'm not feeling old at all. I feel like I was I had a semi-retirement, and I just felt like I was missing out a little bit, mate. Watching all the other kids have fun, do you know what I mean? And not being allowed out, it was a bit meh. So,
yeah,
I had to get back in.
I mean, it's part of it, the fact that when you look at your record, you've gone good rounds with good operators, and they're the only ones you've lost to, really, as well. So it's like you've been operating at a very good level.
Yeah, mate, I've done that. Yeah, it's true. I've done loads of rounds, and I've been in with good opposition. And so I don't feel... I haven't got so many miles on the tank, really. And yeah, there's just a lot more to give.
You come back to the ring after about 2 or 3 years. I think 3 years against Nikita Basin, I think I've said that right, and stopped him in the first round. So did that give you the confidence boost you needed to sort of plough on with this comeback?
Yes, definitely. Yeah, it was like perfect execution. Everyone said, look, can you make it last a little bit longer? But I mean, that comeback was a year in the making, you know. I literally started training in the October 2020 and just you know, started with running every day and doing that because I'd not put the gloves on for 2 years. And so I had to just make sure I could still do it. And, you know, I didn't want to get 2 months into a comeback. I didn't want to announce it straight away. I didn't want to get 2 months into it and then realise, nah, sod this, you know what I mean? And have announced it and then changed my mind and we've just been like a failure. So I did have to test it, you know, I tested it and it was a year in the making. So for the fight to only last 30 seconds, really it was almost like a year and 30 seconds, you know what I mean? So there's a lot of work behind it and it is what it is.
Yeah, I can see now, just looking at BoxRec, that your schedule, you're doing it the right way. You're getting one more little sharpener up there, hopefully try and get a few rounds by the looks of it. And then you're going straight back into a good domestic 50-50 with Chad Sugden. So this is like a good, you're not wasting too much time, are you? You're getting straight back in the mix.
No, definitely. I don't have a lot of time to waste, mate. I mean, listen, time ain't really on my side. I don't feel old at all, but obviously there's young lads at 20 years old and they're coming through and, you know, I've got a family and I've got a, you know, a life and a, but for me it it would have been even sooner. I was hoping because the English was vacant or is vacant. So it has been since, you know, last year or whatever, but ideally I would have already been, maybe have already fought for the English, but everything happens for a reason. And yeah, I got this, like you say, another sort of keep busy warm-up one on the weekend, like Saturday. And then we're hoping to get that one with Chad Sugden, hoping to hear back today if they'll sanction it for the English title.
Yeah, I couldn't see why not. I mean, and at light heavy, there's a division of quite a lot of good fighters who are just waiting for an opportunity. So I'm sure you'll be able to get some good fights in there. I remember doing an interview with Martin Murray at the age of 34. I think it was just before he fought. I can't remember who he fought. He was a good fighter though. And he was just saying he trains smarter. He still has an intense training session, but he just trains a bit smarter. Is that how you sort of approach sparring or training, or are you training exactly the same as you used to do in your 20s?
No, yeah, you're absolutely right. Yeah, definitely. Just train smarter. Listen to your body. Obviously, more mature head on my shoulders, but like realizing that, I mean, you walk in the gym and you are in better shape than when you leave. You go to the gym to get fit, to get strong, to whatever. You're actually in worse shape leaving the gym. That means basically what I'm saying is that you don't make the gains, you don't make the improvements until you've had the good rest. And at like a slightly older age, I do believe that you do need a little bit more rest. So yeah, I mean, I've got to introduce a little, like a midweek rest day as well. Like today is a bit of a down day. Obviously this week is tapering anyway, but yeah, so it is different. I don't spar half as much. I used to spar so much like three times a week at least. And it was, they were all hard spars. I don't do that. So yeah, it's more quality over quantity, and it is just from learning more about how to actually make improvements in your health and your body and your fitness and everything like that, and your strength, everything, speed. You need to have them good rest periods, otherwise you're not making any gains. You're just running and redlining the whole time, and it's not good. It's not good for improvements or just for longevity or anything.
Yeah. No, there's some good tips there. Very good tips. I'm sure people listening to that would be interested to on your take on that. You know, ultimately, what's the goal then? You know, you mentioned the English title, which is a very attainable. It could be in your next couple of fights. Is the goal for this sort of chapter of your career to get to the British title?
Yes. Yes, that's the goal. 100%. I don't think I'm out of place saying that, or out of Lawrence saying that. That's the one that I was... I was on the verge of the British title before. I was looking at when I lost my English title, it was a British title eliminator. And for one reason or another, I wasn't ready for it then, and I wasn't right for it then. It was more mentally than anything else. But yeah, like I said, with a more mature head on my shoulders, I believe it's attainable. I'm much more focused on what I want to do. I recognise that it is the last chance. I know that sounds a bit crap saying it like that, but that's what it is now for me. So I know, I realise the intensity and the sort of professionalism I have to use when it comes to doing this now. I've got a lot more respect for the game as it is. And yeah, you do have to, you know, you do not play boxing. We always say it, you do not play boxing. You can play a lot of sports, but you do not play boxing.
Well, it sounds like you're approaching this in a very methodical and like quite a mature manner, which is always going to be dangerous. You know, with age comes experience at the end of the day, doesn't it? So I'm looking forward to seeing this this comeback, because, like I say, the light heavyweight division is always one I've enjoyed watching, and you're one fight away from getting straight back in the mix there. Well, obviously, we're based in the north, in Manchester. So can you shout out your Instagram handles and your social media handles for everyone, so everyone in the north can get on board with, you know, the southern guys as well?
Yeah, so really, more than anything, I use the Instagram. You can search my name, it'll come up. Or you can search Yakka is here, but for some reason I've got that as my handle. It's just the name is a hard spelling for a lot of people. It's a YAKKAISHERE, and that's the handle. But yeah, just search my name if you want to get on and follow. I keep the content updated very often. It's all pretty good content. We've got a great gym that I train out of, base camp in Hillsey in Portsmouth. It's a friend of mine's gym, and it's a serious like facility. We've got good videographer down there, so we always do good content. And yeah, I mean, follow us if you like boxing, if you like what you see, then yeah, support, it's all good.
Top mate. And I'm behind you, because you're doing it for the over 30s, and I respect that as well. And I've seen a lot of fighters in that stage of their career actually get even more dangerous and more wily. So looking forward to it, mate. And do you want to say anything on a final note?
No, just based on that, though. I mean, look at Nonito Donaire. He done it. He was always a good, like a real one of my favourites. And he looked like he was going to be coming through this Filipino flash, like going to really ruin a few people. For some reason, one reason or another, it slowed down. I think he had a kid at one point, and it might have just took his foot off the pedal a little bit. That was a good few years back. But he's literally just come back and done it, and he's 38 years old. He had a great fight with Inoue, who was the monster. And, you know, he didn't win that, but he won his next run. And it was, like I say, his comeback, world champion, 38 years old. That's an inspiration to anyone. And, his next one, he's got Inoue again. And Inoue is like, it's just something else. But it'll be a good fight, whatever happens. But, yeah, that's it. Over 30s.
Look at people like Golovkin still going well. Look at Chocolatito. I always remember back in the day watching Lennox Lewis getting even better into his late 30s. So, you know, it can be done, mate.
It's a mental, I always say it's a mental game, and it's a mental as in mental upstairs. And if you get the maturity and you get the, I mean, another one, well, not necessarily over 30s, I don't know how old he is, but Rosado, he's just come up against this monster, this young monster who's going for him like this. I can't remember the guy's name that he fought though. This is the one before even. I don't think he was there to win, you know. He's Rosado, he's a a fan favourite, and also like a, always an entertaining fight. And so always getting them fights. This New Yorker, very popular, and he fought the Bully. They call him the Bully. I can't remember the kid's name.
No, exactly. I can picture it in my head. It's going to annoy me, so I'm looking on BoxRec, and then I'm going to edit that.
Yeah, look up. But yeah, he... yeah, again, he wasn't meant to, but what it was is this kid's eventually just powerful, swinging, like trying to take his head off, and the smarter guy...
Yeah, Munguia.
What was his name?
Yeah, Munguia. Jamie Munguia.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, then, and like as I say, and then it eventually caught him, and that was it. It came over. The older guy, the more experienced guy, took care of business.
Oh, yeah, I think you're actually talking about Betkamir Melizukiv, which is the unbeaten Kazakh, I think, and he knocked him out.
Kazakh, yeah.
But yeah, I get the point, mate. I mean, and also Gabe Brizardo, they were calling him a journeyman at one stage, and then he comes in and does that.
Yeah.
The world is your oyster, and you actually are only 34. There's fighters that are going on way later than that at the minute. So, you know, it's all good. It's all good.
Yeah, man, I've looked after myself.
Yeah, so, man. Well, I'm looking forward to it, mate. And I appreciate your time this morning. And
you too,
interview out this evening. And all the best of luck on Saturday night.
Yeah, thank you, Aki. Yeah, good interview, mate. Really appreciate it.